hardworking men and women to do that job. So we appreciate them. Unfortunately, we're still dealing with the fires out there, and we're getting the smoke here in the Duke City to this day. We've been dealing with the hazy skies for about 3 to 4 days now, and it doesn't look to really disappear until a couple days from now. I want to start you off with this cool looking photo that we got in from Randy of some thunderstorms that actually fired up last Friday evening in and around the metro area. So pretty cool sight right there. When it comes to the Doppler radar, we're tracking a few of these storms now starting to develop across the southern portions of the state. We will see a good crop of storms later on this afternoon. We just got to get a little bit more heating going on. You can see the cumulus clouds starting to build over the mountains. 73 or 78 degrees, that is, as we walk out the door this afternoon. It's pretty comfy, and temperatures will be very similar to what we had yesterday. You can see the 70s, if not low 80s, already building in across southern New Mexico. Hourly forecast for us here in the Duke City, we're going to top out in those mid to upper 80s later on today before eventually falling into the 70s by 10 o'clock, bottoming out in the 60s overnight. But really, when it comes to the afternoon highs, like I said, what you had yesterday is pretty much the same kind of thing you can expect this afternoon, except for the eastern plains. You guys will be warmer today compared to that nice cool day you had yesterday thanks to that front. Now, the storm chances, like I said, look pretty impressive, especially for the higher terrain today. We're seeing a little bit more moisture moving in from the south. And as far as the favorable areas go, we're going to include the entire western half of the state looking at the spotty storms today, and the same kind of setup again tomorrow. Again, mountain regions will do better than the rest, but even here in the Duke City, we have a chance of picking up a spot storm by the time we finish up today. As we head into tomorrow, high pressure is slowly starting to build over the state. Now, it's not impossible to see the storms go up. We're just not going to see great coverage, especially out across the eastern plains. And by later end of this week, we'll be watching for a few isolated storms, but the temperatures do start to heat up towards this weekend. We will see more sunshine by Saturday. And you'll notice that in these 7-day forecasts, temperatures won't go up and down as much as what they did last week, but we'll still be watching for a little bit of a fluctuation, especially in southern Colorado. You'll notice from the
Okay. Thank you, Kristen.
Of course.
One.